What a fun and unexpected trio. Thank you for coming on the show tonight. You guys have some big news that you're going to announce tonight. You're doing something together. What is it?
Yeah, you know, Peyton hosted the Country Music Awards. Kelly's one of the greatest of all time. So the three of us are going to do an album.
Oh, is that what this is? Wow, that's fantastic.
We'll be here all weekend.
But yeah, or...
No, in all seriousness, it's an honor to be able to announce for the first time anywhere that this year at the Summer Olympics in Paris, the opening ceremony will be hosted by yours truly, Peyton Manning, and Kelly Clarkson.
Come on now! That's what I'm talking about! What's up? Let's go! Let's go! Come on! Wow! Unprecedented.
Best.
I'm so glad we can say it.
Yes.
We've been holding this for, I'm not a vault. I hate secrets. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. This is a giant deal.
Yeah.
You're going to Paris.
Paris.
Ooh.
It's going to be pretty cool. Yeah.
July 26th is when it kicks off in Paris. And you actually brought with you the gold medals. So we can look at the gold medals. I've never seen these. These are for the Olympics and the Paralympics right here. Wow.
Is it heavy? Is it heavy?
Yeah, you can do it. Yeah, you want to hold it?
Oh, wow.
They're actually really heavy.
That's really, really heavy.
They're the only ones that are in the U.S. as of right now. And the coolest part of those, each one has a little piece of the Eiffel Tower in it. So if you win a medal, not only do you get your gold, silver, or bronze, you get a piece of the Eiffel Tower to take with you for life.
Are you kidding me?
There
you go.
That's so cool.
This is amazing. I'm so happy you brought this and brought this news with you. You guys are all so accomplished in your own right. I was going to ask you, if you were ever going to win a gold medal in anything else but something you've won an award in, what would it be? Like, I would win a gold medal in blank. Peyton?
Ooh, event planning.
What?
I'm planning?
What do you do?
Yeah, it's kind of my true calling. I'm planning a birthday in December. I've already told all my friends what to wear, what time to be there, what time they should shower the night before.
Wow, you really are into,
I think I would take gold in event planning.
Okay.
We're connected because I'm the same thing. If you want to travel and get to an airport, that's what I do half the year. Mm. Like, I'm the guy who's packed the night before, the bag is ready to go.
You are.
I might, if you run a little late, tell you that the flight's 15 minutes earlier than it really is. I'm that guy.
You're that guy.
You've traveled with me already.
Pretty much. I'm getting ready for you.
Yeah.
I am not like that at all.
You know.
I hate planning vacations. I just want to say where we're going, and then we'll just end up where we end up.
What would you win the Olympic gold? What would you win a gold medal in if you...
I am the Simone Biles of Legos. I am incredible. I am incredible at Legos.
At Legos?
Yeah. It's a true thing. I'm incredible. You should see my house. It's weird. I'm an adult, but it's weird. I do it with my son mostly.
Yeah, of course. I get into it too, and it gets too hard for me, so I just let my kids take it over.
People who make the instructions for Legos should make them for everything.
They're great, right?
They're so easy.
Yeah, but if you miss one step, the whole thing is like, oh my gosh. You go, where's this one little tiny piece?
I don't miss a step.
Wow. this is big news. You guys, Paris, I heard the opening ceremony is going to be on the River Seine.
Yeah.
And that's going to be gorgeous. Are you going over there? Do any of you speak French, Peyton?
Je parle français un peu.
Whoa.
Go ahead.
Wow.
The name Peyton just kind of lends itself to being pronounced in French. Je m'appelle Peyton.
Peyton.
So
I took a little French in high school, and I told my mother I would take her to Paris one day. 30 years to the time I graduated, I'm taking my mom to Paris for the Olympics.
You are going to do it?
Ceremony. I'm taking her.
So. Taking mom!
Absolutely.
So, the best, bud.
Parlez-vous français, Jimmy?
Not really. No, I was gonna say un poquito. I don't know that's just not the right answer. Yeah, I'm not good. Do you speak French?
No. And that is translated no.
That was French.
Yes, wow. It's I say with an accent, Paris.
That works.
No, I did, however, switch my Duolingo. I was in Spanish world. I have been in French world now. So yeah, by the time I get there, I should. Well, be that annoying American that tries to speak French.
Yeah. You'll do it. Tariqa?
Nothing. Rosetta Stone for the spring and summer.
Okay, good. All right, perfect. We'll
just
train. We'll all train.
Yes. Yeah.
Peyton, I was going to ask you, as far as athletes go, what advice do you give the athletes or anything if you're friends of an athlete? Because if you're an athlete and you win, you obviously say congratulations. But what if you don't win? What do you say to an athlete?
Yeah, it's a great question because there were no fans and family allowed at the Olympics 4 years ago. So it's great to have the fans and families back at the Olympics here in Paris. But, yeah, when things don't go well for the athlete, the silence sometimes is deafening, Jimmy. People just don't say anything to you.
Yeah.
And I would argue you want to reach out to your friend and say, hey, I'm in your corner. I'm proud of you. I love you. You don't want to rehash the event. Like, I always had this friend who used to say, hey, I'm sorry about the 4 interceptions you just threw. I'm like, yes.
I remember.
I was just there.
That was me. That was me, yeah.
Thanks for the recap. but like I said, don't go silent. You know, don't say, sorry, you false started 4 times, you hit every hurdle, and you trip before
you
the finish
that.
Line.
But yeah, just say I love you.
Yeah, reach out. Let them know that you're thinking about them, that you're in their corner.
They made it to the Olympics. You win.
Yes.
That's winning.
That is winning just being there. You actually made it to the Olympics.
Yeah.
Mike, what can you tell us about the Olympics? You've done this. You're a master at it.
I'm lucky enough to do this now for the 4th time. The opening ceremony is going to be so different and unique, down the Seine, down the river, with the athletes on a boat. So it's not the stadium where they walk in. It'll incorporate Paris. And the games are going to be amazing, as you know, swimming, gymnastics.
Who do we have to look out for?
Simone Biles, Katie Ledecky, just legends of their sport. They'll be back. Team USA in track and field could be incredibly strong. The Dream Team, the U.S. soccer team, the women's basketball team. The second week. Are you coming to Paris?
I'm not, but I will be watching. I will be tuning in. I'll be watching on Peacock.
I think you should come the second week.
You should come.
Because we have all those teams and the track and field.
I will come.
Will you come?
Of course I will come.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
If you come to Paris, would you do the closing ceremony with me?
Are you serious?
Do I have to get on my knee when you say yes?
Are you serious?
Do I have to get on my knee? I'm asking you. Please say yes.
Is this real?
Yes, this is real.
I'm in. I'm going to do it.